This is a version 006 of my Buderus KM271 Wi-Fi. Now I'll show you how I flash the firmware with my Pogo adapter. Means when there is no pin header for debugging installed. Now I enter my flash program. This resets and enables the IO0 pin and then flashes the firmware as soon as the ESP32 responds with the programming status. The green flashing LED indicates that it is not connected to any Wi-Fi and needs to be configured to connect to your Wi-Fi. Since I'll install the power select header, I need to remove the jumper resistors R67 and R68. Now I'm removing the excess solder from production of the board. Rolling up over black Cadillac, high heel boots and a sexy body full of tats. Baby's bad, oh baby's hella bad. After her there ain't no coming back. Next step is to solder the debug connector. First solder one pin, then align the connector. And then soldering the remaining pins. And also re-solder the first, so it is not a cold solder. Next step is to solder the USB connector. This is only needed if you want to power the board via USB. Usually it's powered by the Buderus control unit. Makes no sense to solder the pins one by one. Better solder them all together and then they remove the excess solder. It's a bit hard to solder because it's a ground plane that takes away the heat very much. Next,
soldering the power selection header. Next is the extension header. Again, first soldering a single pin. Aligning the connector correctly on both sides. And then start to solder the whole row. Next step is to solder the header for the wire connections. I first take a bit of solder to fix one pin. Best to use not one of the ground pins because of the thermal problem. Take an opposite pin to fix it, and then you can easily solder all the other pins. Next are the electrolytic capacitors. Take care that you do not swap positive and negative terminals. They can explode. The longer pin usually is a positive connector. Again, first soldering one pin. Then aligning the capacitors. And then solder the second pin. Then you need to cut the wires. And because if you cut the wires, you can also damage the solder pin, you should usually re-solder the pins you have cut. Now we break away the remainders of the PCB. These panel strips are usually needed that it's easier to assemble the boards in the factory. Then we just remove the sharp edges. Using isopropyl alcohol, we clean the flux from the PCB. And then we remove the protective foils from the gold fingers. Okay, the board is ready. Now we can set the jumpers. Usually the middle one is needed always. And then you need to decide if you want to supply the board from the Buderus control unit, then set the jumper in this position. Or if you want to supply it from the USB connector, set the jumper on the other side. I'll put it on the Buderus side so it just works. If you now connect it to power, we usually see the test program running, and if you order the ESPhome one, I'll flash the ESPhome firmware. Okay, now you see that the green LED flashing slowly indicates that it has no connection to Wi-Fi. We also test the USB power connection, so we set the jumper on the right place, and as soon as we connect, the ESP should start with ESPhome firmware. And it works. If you don't have an ESP programming cable at hand, but only a standard USB to serial TTL cable, you can emulate the programming sequence by pressing boot and reset simultaneously and releasing reset first. You also need to press reset after programming has finished to start the application. If you are interested in the reverse engineering of the Buderus KM271 or other tinkering projects, you can visit my blog. The link is in the video description. If you enjoyed the video, please leave me a like and subscribe to my channel. And never forget to keep digging.